Now, I want to show a book that I didn't write, but it came from here. I Love New York, Strategic Prayer Guide. Every key city needs a book like this. It is that key. I have gone through it more than once. It's just an excellent, excellent guide that where we don't have to go back and reinvent all of what we've reinvented during the prayer movement since the early 90s. We have that. We're up to speed with that. Now, how are we going to use this to speak into the atmosphere, to recreate the atmosphere? And what authority will we be speaking from? So that's very important. So last night we started. We started with Staten Island, and we started by, Aaron, go ahead, Staten Island saying that it was a place of birthing, and that we were going to start birthing the new. Well, God took us there, and he took us there for a reason. Just the anniversary of when General Howe started trying to come through to stop the formation of America. So you see, I think we're walking differently. And the way we worshiped last night and the way we decreed said this thing is beginning new and fresh. And this next move of God is beginning new and fresh. And now we're here in Queens. Now, this is what I see about Queens. Queens is, Aaron, Queens is the Flushing in Queens is where the angels are going to start harvesting. And flushing out things that need to be flushed out, because in harvest you have a threshing floor. And threshing floor is always part of harvest, and it's where all the separation starts. And I see Queens as a key harvesting center and a model harvesting center for the future. And it's very key. And another pay word that you have to factor in with this is it is the word Holy Spirit. It is an era of Holy Spirit. See, Holy Spirit is a key pay word, and it actually means I'm going to start breaking the curses. It's not just being our advocate, our comforter, but Holy Spirit is who breaks the curse that started from your house. So we're going to start seeing a Holy Spirit move where curses that have developed and built up in the house are going to start being broken. And that's going to cause a lot of deliverance and a lot of harvesting. But it's not going to be like we've expected in the past. It's going to be more of what Peter said. All of a sudden, you're going to be walking into Costco, and the Spirit of God's going to hit you, and it's going to all happen right there. Then you're going to say, I got the right altar to bring you to make sure that you are staying connected right for your future. See, because the church, the word means fellowship. It means gathering, but it also means a warring troop. He brought them out by armies. So that is our first model of him gathering each one of these tribes, bringing them out by armies, and saying, here's my redemptive plan, and this is how you'll have to war for your promise. That brings us up to where we are right now. All we have done up to now, in this last era, God's saying, I am ready to start harvesting this. And so, what we did last night was we started recognizing the angels that are necessary to come into this territory to start helping us, that government of God in heaven. And see, we are the army of the Lord in the earth realm, and the two have to align together so that we accomplish this new harvest call that God's giving us. Now, with that, that becomes very important for us to see that is one of God's plans and patterns that he has always used. He always has used this angelic alignment. See, that was why David's biggest sin really wasn't with his problem that he had with Bathsheba, which led him to murder. I mean, you know, if David can make it, we can all make it up into heaven. But he had a heart after God. But that wasn't the thing that really brought devastation. It was when he decided to go to war, and to go to war, he numbered all the people. Well, I mean, there's a whole book on numbers, and God always numbered the tribes. Why was that so devastating? Well, because David was looking at it only from earth view. And what he had done was he had cut off the army of heaven to come in, like the army of heaven had always come in every war, to assist in the endeavor of triumph. And he had to learn a very hard lesson by losing thousands of people. So I felt like I watched for that last night, and I think Cheryl brought it up, and I think it was brought up by someone even before Cheryl, where this angelic host needed to come in, because if not, in this incredible conflict that will come across New York. Now, that was a prophetic word for you in a very nice way. It will be an incredible conflict across New York, and you want to be sure to have all the angels you need aligned to help you harvest in that conflict.